So, what was this Cold War? This Cold War was not the actual battle was happening, not the actual battle was ensuing between the groups or between the countries, but these were happening in the mindset of the nations. Okay? So, there were two blocks, capitalist bloc. And the socialist or the communist bloc. Good afternoon, friends. So today we have taken up a topic from the GS portion of post-independence. So the topic is Nehruvian foreign policy with special reference to non-aligned movement. Here I have written short form of non-aligned movement as NAM. So it is non-aligned movement. Non-aligned movement. Okay. So before getting into the actual topic, let's trace the background of Nehruvian foreign policy with special reference to NAM. Okay. So let's talk about the condition which were prevailing at that point of time. So these were 1940s and 50s. The world was still in a fray or still in a race to come out of the shock waves that were sent by Second World War. Okay, there were massive destruction of both in terms of man and money. So apart from that destruction, there was another development was decolonization of the empires. Decolonization. Decolonization of the empires, it implies that the erstwhile colonial powers, now they're losing their control over their colonial empire, and independent nationalities were coming up on the scene. So newly independent nations, they came on the scene, and together they came to be known as third world countries. Fine. So these were third world countries. So basically, the third world countries, there were two categories of third world countries also. The first category comprised of countries, third world countries, who have gained nationhood through a prolonged struggle, such as India. India had gained through a long struggle for independence, India has gained nationhood, India has gained independence. But there are certain nations in Africa and in Latin America which have gained nationhood by sudden withdrawal of the colonial masters. Okay, suddenly क्या हुआ है कि उनका जो कॉलोनियल मास्टर है, बी इट जर्मनी हो, जर्मनी और फ्रांस और ब्रिटेन, वो इट्स सडनली इट वेनिश्ड अवे इन द फ्रॉम द सीन, एंड the nation or the nation in the making process which already had not taken place in such nations. So there were a lot of problems. One major problem was political fragility. Okay, political fragility was one major problem in such newly independent nations. So we were discussing about the 1940s and 50s that newly independent nations, they came up on the scene, and these recently independent nations were on internal front, they were facing lot of problems such as political instabilities, political instability, border disputes, socio-economic problems like poverty and illiteracy, socio-economic problems. Also, in certain nations of Africa and Latin America, there were military coups. So this also led to the political instability and frequent dismantling of the elected governments in such nations. So I already told you there are two categories. So these fall under second category. So these were the internal disputes. We are talking about Nehruvian foreign policy, background of Nehruvian foreign policy. How did it Nehruvian foreign policy got shaped? So it got shaped during because of certain issues, because of certain problems, okay, which were the driving force behind Nehruvian foreign policy. So apart from this, these were the internal problems, or these were the some of them were bilateral problems, but there existed a larger problem also, and that larger problem was of Cold War. Cold War. So what was this Cold War? This Cold War was not the actual battle was happening, not the actual battle was ensuing between the groups or between the countries, but these were happening in the mindset of the nations. Okay, so there were two blocks, capitalist bloc and the socialist or the communist bloc. This bloc was led by US or United States of America, and this bloc was led by USSR. Okay. So communist nations were in this bloc. So there was war of mentalities. There was war of ideology or ideas. Everywhere across the world, capitalists, what they were trying? They were trying to dominate, or they were trying to prove their point that they are good. And the communists, on the other hand, they are trying that their system is best. Okay. So, in the entire process, what they were doing, they were lobbying down the support from third world countries. Okay. So, they were getting support, they are trying to influence third world countries to join their particular bloc. So, these third world countries were already facing lot of problems. Sometimes due to temptation, they got lured and they might join capitalist bloc, or some might join communist bloc. So, that was the main issue. So, Nehruvian foreign policy, the one important plank was non-aligned movement. So, this important plank of Nehruvian policy, it implied that we are not going to join any of the bloc, be it so capitalist bloc or be it communist bloc. Okay, we will remain separate. So, the countries which remain aloof or which remain separated from these two bloc or the bloc politics, they came to be known as non-aligned countries. Okay, and this was one important plank of Nehruvian foreign policy. Okay, so what Nehru envisioned that under the temptation or under the lure, these two bloc powers, they are using them as pawn of contest. They were merely pawn in this contest, and at the same time we have our own problem. We have problems like poverty, illiteracy, disease. We have problem like political and military coup. So many countries, third world countries, they were already struggling. So Nehru was of the view that in such a scenario, instead of going for socio-economic reconstruction or nation building process, if we go after this bloc politics, then we are definitely going to suffer. Okay. So to minimize this suffering, or to keep third world countries away from this suffering, Nehruvian foreign policy, it decided not to join the bloc politics. So bloc politics mein kya ho raha tha ki bloc politics mein regional groups were coming up in Asia. Regional groups were coming up. Even today, regional groups are there, like ASEAN, like RCEP, Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, or Trans-Pacific Partnership. So, still there, regional groups are there. So, at the same time, the regional groups, they were coming up, like SEATO, Southeast Atlantic Treaty Organization, or CENTO. And the Western European nation, they have already joined NATO. That was a military alliance treaty of collective, it was a kind of collective security. The main idea was collective security, that if somebody is attacking any one of them, then it is taken as an attack on all of them, and all of them would resist the power which is going to attack them. Fine. So Nehru wanted to transform this area or zone of war and hostility into a zone of peace and tranquility. Zone of peace and tranquility. ओके, जोन ऑफ पीस एंड ट्रांक्विलिटी. ओके, सो बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, इफ वी कम अप टू डिस्कस बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ नेहरूवियन पॉलिसी, सो वन सच इम्पॉर्टेंट ऑब्जेक्टिव वॉज टू फाइट अगेंस्ट कोल्ड वॉर, नॉट टू रिमेन साइलेंट बट टू बी वोकल इन देयर सपोर्ट टू थर्ड वर्ल्ड कंट्रीज अगेंस्ट दिस ब्लॉक पॉलिटिक्स. ओके, सो नेहरूवियन पॉलिटिक्स, इट वॉज, इट स्टूड फॉर सोशियो इकोनॉमिक रिकॉन्स्ट्रक्शन नेशन बिल्डिंग ऑफ थर्ड वर्ल्ड कंट्रीज कीपिंग डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम ब्लॉक पॉलिटिक्स एंड लेट मी टेल यू वन इंपॉर्टेंट इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑफ ब्लॉक पॉलिटिक्स वॉज नियो कॉलोनियलिज्म. एज द नेम सजेस्ट, नाम से पता चल रहा है, नियो, दैट इट वॉज ए न्यू फॉर्म ऑफ कॉलोनियलिज्म. इट वॉज नॉट ए कॉलोनियलिज्म वेयर ए ट्रेडिंग कंपनी वुड कम, इट विल स्टार्ट बार्गेनिंग फॉर समथिंग एंड देन इट विल कॉन्कर द एंटायर एरिया बाय हुक और बाय कुक. ओके, दैट्स वॉट हैज हैपन्ड ड्यूरिंग द डेज ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन, गॉड, ग्लोरी एंड वेल्थ. ओके, सो नियो कॉलोनियलिज्म में क्या होगा, समटाइम इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज डॉलर डिप्लोमेसी. सो द एरिया वुड बी अंडर द गार्ब ऑफ, अंडर द व्हील ऑफ एड कंडीशनर, एड प्रोवाइडिंग एड, सर्टेन कंडीशंस वर अटैच्ड दैट यू हैव टू सपोर्ट अस. अब नाउ थर्ड वर्ल्ड कंट्री, दे आर ऑलरेडी पुअर एंड अंडर प्रिविलेज, सो दे वर लुकिंग फॉर एड फ्रॉम वेस्टर्न कंट्रीज. सो दे वेंट फॉर एड कंडीशनलिटी एंड दी कंडीशनलिटीज केम डाउन हैवी ऑन देम. दिस वॉज ए फॉर्म ऑफ न्यू कॉलोनियलिज्म. दिस वॉज न्यू कॉलोनियलिज्म एंड अंडर दिस न्यू कॉलोनियलिज्म मैनी थर्ड वर्ल्ड कंट्रीज सच एज वियतनाम, सच एज फिलीपींस एंड मैनी अदर्स, दे लॉस्ट द बेसिक एसेंस ऑफ न्यूली इंडिपेंडेंट, देयर न्यूली एक्वायर्ड न्यूली इंडिपेंडेंस बिकॉज ऑफ दैट. एंड इंडिया सक्सेसफुली अंडर द फॉलोइंग नेहरूवियन फॉरेन पॉलिसी, इंडिया सक्सेसफुली डिड दिस. ओके, सो वन हॉलमार्क ऑफ नेहरूवियन फॉरेन पॉलिसी वॉज पंचशील. पंचशील, द नेम वॉज टेकन फ्रॉम बुद्धिस्ट डॉक्ट्रिन्स एंड इट स्टूड फॉर म्यूचुअल रिस्पेक्ट फॉर ईच अदर्स टेरिटोरियल इंटीग्रिटी. Mutual respect for each other territorial integrity, which means we will not encroach upon others' territory. Okay? सेकंड कंपोनेंट ऑफ पंचशील वाज नॉन एग्रेशन ऑन अदर्स, दैट इंडिया विल नॉट अटैक एनीवन। ओके, सो नॉन एग्रेशन। थर्ड मेन कंपोनेंट ऑफ पंचशील वाज नॉन इंटरफेरेंस। नॉन इंटरफेरेंस मीन्स नॉन इंटरफेयरिंग इन इंटरनल अफेयर ऑफ अदर कंट्रीज। इफ समथिंग इज हैपनिंग इन नेबरिंग कंट्री और सम अदर कंट्री, देन इंडिया विल नॉट इंटरवीन। ओके, बिकॉज इट इज लाइक इट इज अनदर फॉर्म ऑफ बॉसिज्म। ओके, एंड दैट इज वॉट द वेस्टर्न कंट्रीज हैव बीन डूइंग। The block politics was all about intervention, undue intervention into the affairs of third world countries. Let them enjoy their independence and let them solve their problem by providing some kind of help, some kind of aid. But that was not happening. Okay? Then fourth important component of Panchsheel was equality and mutual benefit. That equality should be given to a nation, be it a small nation or be it a large nation. Okay? And we should stood for mutual benefit. We will do anything which is mutually beneficial for us. Okay? Then fifth component was peaceful coexistence. Peaceful coexistence means that we will remain in peace and we will let you remain in the peace. So I told you that Nehru wanted to turn the zone of war and hostility into zone of peace and tranquility. So this component of Panchsheel was outcrop of that feeling only. Okay, so now let's talk about Nam. After Panchsheel, let's talk about Nam. Or non-aligned movement, how the idea was generated, how it progressed, and what it did, and did it succeeded in the mission, or it failed in the first place, and in the present time, how it is relevant for us. Okay, so. As we see that its aim was to India's Nehruvian foreign policy's aim was to promote or protect chiefly socio-economic interest of India, and India's economic interests were paramount importance for them. So concerted efforts of nations, of particularly the third world countries, were needed at this moment of bloc politics or the Cold War. So initially, during 1940s and 50s, Asian relation conferences were held. This was to create a sense of belongingness, a sense of brotherhood, a sense of common fear or a sense of common past among the third world countries. Okay, and to show them the real threat of bloc politics or taking part in the Cold War. Okay, so one such conference was held in Bandung in 1955 in Indonesia, and there the decision टू क्रिएट ए बॉडी और क्रिएट ए फोरम सच एज नॉन अलाइन मूवमेंट इन द नियर फ्यूचर वॉज टेकन अप बाय पीएम नेहरू फ्रॉम इंडिया गमाल अब्दुल नासिर from Egypt, Marshal Tito, from Yugoslavia, Yugoslovakia. And the Indonesian president. So Nam was brainchild of these political leaders, and the decision was taken in 1955 in Bandung. Although idea was in the fray since. The Cold War itself came into existence, but it actually got concretized during 1955 in Bandung in Indonesia. Okay, so in 1961 in Yugoslavia, Yugoslavian capital Belgrade, first summit of NAM was taken. And here in this summit, it was resolved that we should use our wider geographical basis. We should not spoil our nascent independence or newly gained independence, which has came after so much struggle. Okay, so it was decided to be away from any military block or any or building any military bases at the behest of any Cold War or any Cold War or any block power politics. Okay, so NAM played its important role. NAM's role came primarily during Korean War. During Korean War, in 1950-53, India played a major role, and it was also success of Nehruvian foreign policy. It is one important example of success of Nehruvian foreign policy, and it was recognized after Korean War when India played an important role as an interlocutor between South Korea and North Korea. Okay, so it was an important milestone or landmark in the growth of India's foreign policy. Okay, so Korean War was one important test of the success of non-aligned movement. One important success of non-aligned movement was the primacy it gave to UN. UN after Second World War, United Nations Organization was kept alive by non-aligned movement because of the primacy. But even in the border disputes, the internationalization of the matter, or the matter was taken to the UNO, and UNO was there to mediate the dispute between the two parties, such as Indus Water Treaty between India and Pakistan. So that was happening. So non-aligned movement, though it failed in resolving problems like Kashmir problem and host of other problems which are happening in Middle East or in the Arab world, but it was successful in number of occasions. So it was one important successful parameter or measure of Nehruvian foreign policy. Okay, so it was helpful in protecting the third world countries. It was helpful in protecting the national sovereignties of the third world countries. It stood for multilateralism. It stood for multilateralism. That is, that the distribution of power should be an even one. It should not remain concentrated in few hands. It should be in every nation should be powerful enough so that there would be no another third world war. Okay, so multilateralism, it also contributed to the cause of disarmament. Third world countries members, they were particularly they were aware of the threat of nuclear war in the coming years, because during the Cold War the condition were such that US and USSR both were equipped with lot of nuclear weapons. So there was a perception that the third world war would wipe out mankind in the near future. So what the non-aligned countries did, except India and Pakistan, most of them, they went for signing nuclear non-proliferation treaty. Nuclear non-proliferation treaty. Okay, so most of them signed it. So these were few of the credits to the non-aligned movement. And in the present times, in the face of bipolarity, now there is Cold War is not there. However, now the world is bipolar. Now the world is dominated by Chinese aggression. Okay. Now the world is dominated by sophisticated nuclear weapons. Now the global problems need global solutions. Global catastrophes, global warming, global terrorism, they need global governance. They need a global dialogue happening at the global level. So in such a scenario, the role of NAN cannot be belittled, and its relevance is going to enhance in the near future along with new successes. Okay, so this was all about Nehruvian foreign policy, or important component of Nehruvian foreign policy, and how it in the immediate context of independence, how it succeeded in keeping India away from the wars and battles and focusing upon the development, administration, socio-economic reconstruction, and a nation-building process, which we are reaping today as well. Okay, thank you for the discussion. All the best.